Hello and welcome back to the channel. This is Vic. Sorry, it's taken a long time. This is the first video in our long-awaited 2023 Kden Live tutorial series. So in this video, we're going to go over the steps on how to install Kden Live on your computer. Now, if you don't already know, Kden Live is a free and open source video editor. I use it for editing my personal videos, and I also use it for the production of this very tutorial series that you're watching right now. I love Kden Live because it's free and open source. In addition to that, it's also available on Windows, Mac, and Linux. Now, before we get started, here's some information about the system that I'm using. I'm using a HP Omen 15 laptop. This was released around 2021. I'm using PopOS 22.04 LTS release. So the laptop has an AMD 4600H CPU. It has 32 gigs of memory, which I've upgraded from 16 gigs. It has an NVIDIA 1660 Ti. And the version of Kden Live that we're going to be using for this series is going to be 22.12.2. I'm doing something a little bit different in the series in the sense that I'm not going to be changing or upgrading the version number. So I'm going to try to stick with 22.12.2, not unless we start to encounter a lot of bugs that really affect our work. Now, if you haven't already done so, please click on like and subscribe to the channel. It helps to support the channel and gives me the ability to make these free tutorials for you. And as usual, if you need to skip to a different part of the video, I've included the chapters below. So let's get started with installing Kden Live. We'll talk about Linux first, since this is my base and go-to system. My preferred way for installing and running Kden Live in Linux is actually through a Flatpak. Now, the way to do this is just to go to flathub.org. We can search for Kden Live. It doesn't actually matter what distribution you're on, as long as you've set up Flatpak and Flathub. Now, installing through the command line is very easy. We just copy this command down here. We'll open up a terminal, paste, and press enter. And what this is going to do is it's going to install Kden Live onto our system. I will just press yes, just wait for it to install. And there we have it. Now we have Kden Live running on our system. So let's launch that, see what it looks like. We got Kden Live here, and it says it's the Flatpak version here. Here we have it, Kden Live. Let's just check what version this is. And we got version 22.12.2. So that's the version that we want. Now, another way to install Kden Live is actually to go with the app image. So if we click on download here, we'll see that for Linux, the Penguin, we've got app image, Flatpak, which we actually already covered, and it can also be installed as a PPA. So clicking on the app image link here, it'll download the app image onto our computer. Once our download has finished, let's go to our file manager. Let's check out the downloads folder here, and here is our app image file. When you double-click on this for the first time, it may not open. So what you need to do is right-click, go to Properties, go to Permissions, and make sure that you tick this box, Allow executing a file as a program. Now, when we double-click this, it's going to open up and run as a standalone program. If you want to go with something that is static, meaning that you're going to keep running the same Kden Live version, I would recommend going with the app image file. But if you want to stay up to date all the time, then I recommend going with the Flatpak because the Flatpak will automatically update itself as long as you issue the update command. Whereas with the app image, you have to download each new version manually every time. So that pretty much covers it for the installation of Kden Live on Linux. They also have an Ubuntu PPA, which I don't really recommend unless you really want to go that route. It's also available in the repositories of your distribution. Again, that's not really something that I would recommend. I would recommend either the app image or the Flatpak version. It's just a cleaner install. You don't get any additional dependencies. Like, for example, if you're running a GNOME desktop, and it will install a lot of the KDE dependencies. And if you don't like that messing around with your system, then yeah, definitely app image and Flatpak is the way to go. Now, very quickly with Apple, Kden Live does run on your MacBook or your Apple hardware, except that I've only really tested it running the Intel version. If you're familiar with Macs, it's very simple. You just download the DMG file and you open the DMG file and then you copy that onto your applications folder. And that's it. Double click and Kden Live will run. Now, Windows is very easy. You just download the installable file or the standalone file, you double click, and it will take you through the installation process. Now that pretty much covers it for this video. Very short and sweet, just how to install Kden Live onto your system. If you're using Windows, Mac, the operation should be pretty straightforward. It's a little bit more complicated with Linux. If you want to make your life easy, just choose the app image, double click and run, or you can set up Kden Live as a flat pack. And that's it, and I'll see you in the next video.